to a worship celebration of song and scripture. You can follow along with us as we invite you to participate.
Page 122. Let us pray. Great and mighty God, we thank you for this moment. We thank you for this day, for life itself. We thank you for this Eastertide narrative that you've blessed us with. And oh God, we endeavor to experience the awe, the pain, the delight, and the challenge of the entire narrative on this evening. We pray that you would be with us, that you would hear our cries, hear our moans, that you would heal our hearts, that you would help us along the way to be who you've called us to be in this moment. We pray your blessing, your peace. To your glory we pray, in the name of Jesus, amen. A reading of scripture, 2 Chronicles chapter 5, 11 through 14. Now, when the priests came out of the holy place, for all the priests who were present had sanctified themselves without regard to their divisions, all the liturgical Levitical singers, Asaph, Heman, and Judithan, their sons and kindred, arrayed in fine linen with cymbals, harps, and lyres, they stood east of the altar with 120 priests who were trumpeters. It was the duty of the trumpeters and singers to make themselves heard in unison in praise and thanksgiving to the Lord. And when the song was raised with trumpets and cymbals and other musical instruments in praise to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. The house of the Lord was filled with the cloud, so that the priest could not stand to minister because of the cloud. For the glory of the Lord filled the house of God. The word of the Lord.
The music we're going to minister tonight is gospel music, and it's what we call a collective art. So that means it's not just for us, that means it's for everyone. So we invite you now to clap along, to sing along, to rock along, to pat along, to shout if you want, to stand. But we want to invite the Spirit of the Lord into this place, for when they sang together, the house was filled with his presence. So we ask now, Lord, send your Spirit.
Lord, send your power. Lord, send
So once the Spirit of God does come into the room, what do? You worship and you receive. So tonight we say to you, if you have a need that only God can meet, open your heart and receive. Receive his mercy, receive his miracles, receive his message that comes when we enter the house of the Lord. The next song says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And we know that all that we need will come from God when we worship in his house. Let's worship together.
The house of the Lord, for in his house.
the Lord, all you nations. Extol him, all you peoples. For great is his steadfast love towards us. And the faithfulness of the Lord endures forever. Praise the Lord, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
They were approaching Jerusalem at Bethpage in Bethany near the Mount of Olives. He sent two of his disciples and said, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter, you will find tied there a colt that has been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anybody says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say, 'The Lord needs it,' and we'll send it back here immediately." They went away and found a colt tied near a door, outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing, untying the colt?" They told them that Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We invite you to rise in body or in spirit and share with us as we sing this wonderful song. Turn to page 125, and again, feel free to join in as we celebrate the Savior and Lord. Oh, magnify the Lord with me.
Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Say Hosanna. Everybody say, blessed be the rock. Oh, blessed be the rock of my salvation.
Oh, magnify the Lord.
Oh, magnify the Lord.
For he is worthy.
For he is worthy.
We lift our voice and say,
oh,
Hosanna, Hosanna,
we sing, blessed be the rock.
Oh, blessed
be the rock of my salvation.
Sing Hosanna.
Oh, blessed be the rock.
Blessed be the rock of my salvation.
My salvation.
Oh, magnify.
Oh, magnify the Lord.
For he is worthy.
God of my salvation be exalted.
Sing Hosanna, Hosanna.
came the day of unleavened bread, on which the Passover lamb had been sacrificed. So Jesus sent Peter and John, saying, "Go and prepare the Passover meal for us, that we may eat." They asked him, "Where do you want us to make preparations for it?"
"Listen," he said to them, "when you have entered the city, a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him into the house he enters and say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks you, where is the guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, already furnished. Make preparations for us there."
So they went and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When the hour came, he took his place at the table, and the apostles with him. While they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it. He gave it to them and said,
"Take, this is my body."
Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it. He said to them,
"This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly, I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it anew in the kingdom of God."
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Simon, Simon, listen. Satan has demanded to sift all of you like wheat. But I have prayed for you that your own faith may not fail. And you, when once you have turned back, strengthen your brothers.
And he said to them, Lord, I'm ready to go with you to prison and to death. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I'm determined to walk with Jesus. Yes, I am. I'm determined to walk with Jesus. Yes, I am. Through hard trials, tribulations, persecution, I'll be faithful. I'm determined to walk with Jesus. Yes, I am. I'm determined to walk with Jesus. Yes, I am. Jesus. Yes, I am. I'm determined to walk with Jesus. Yes, I am. Jesus. Yes, I am.
As was his custom, to the Mount of Olives. And the disciples followed him. When he reached the place, he said to them,
pray that you may not come into the time of trial.
Then he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, knelt down and prayed,
Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me. Yet, not my will, but yours be done. And then an angel from heaven appeared to him and gave him strength. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I'm curious, what might have happened had Jesus stopped walking? Sometimes in life we find that we've got to walk through trying times. Sometimes we have to walk alone. But we've got to know that God is still with us. And there are times when you want to give up, but you know you can't. We have to keep walking through our trials until we get to our victories. And we thank God that Jesus kept walking through his trial until he got to triumph. And we thank God that Jesus kept walking so that we might be free. So you too must keep walking so that others might be free. So tonight we say to you, don't give up. You can make it. Walk on.
The crucifixion story is one of many trials and tribulations, turns. It's a story of forgiveness, of salvation, of relationship, of abandonment, of distress, of triumph, and of reunion. We know the accounts of Judas, who betrayed Christ. We know the accounts of Peter, who denied Christ 3 times before the crowd. But we rarely focus on the maiming and the torture and the torment of the physical body of Christ. There was a tradition that at the feast, the governor would bring out 2 accused and put one here and one here and ask the crowd, "Whom shall we release?" Here, Jesus, the Christ, the King of the Jews, and here, Barabbas. The crowd chose Barabbas. So here, Jesus, accused, is disrobed, maimed, beaten, tortured, tormented, and then a scarlet wrap was put over him. Then a crown of thorns was put on his head, and a reed in his right hand. And then they began to shove him and move him and move him and shove him and bruise his body, all the time spitting and spewing on him. Some even took the reed out of his right hand and whipped him and beat him and tormented him with it. Then they stripped him of his robe, and as he moved, carrying the cross, the great agony was there, that he had fallen, he'd fallen, he'd fallen, he'd fallen, he'd fallen. And there was Simon from Cyrene in North Africa, who was chosen to be the one to pull that big cross up to a place called Golgotha. There, they hung him high, and they stretched him wide, and they beat him and bruised him and put nails in his hands. They even put a little drink of concoction together and put it up to his lips. They tore his clothes. And there above his head was a sign that said, "The King of the Jews." But we forget the part of the story where you are to his right and I am to his left. And as he looked and saw us, in my theologically sound and biblically based imagination, I believe that he looked over and winked at you and winked at me and said, "It's going to be all right after a while." All the pain and the agony that he was facing, that he felt, he had enough compassion to look to you and to look to me to comfort just a little. And then he uttered the words, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do." A little while later, he says, "Truly, I say to you," looking at you and looking at me, today you will be with me in paradise. And then he looked down from the cross. Oh, blessed Mother Mary there, and the disciple whom he loved. And he looked at old John and said, and he looked at his mother Mary, and he said, "Woman, behold your son." "Son, behold your mother." And then we felt the utter shake of the cosmos as he yelled out, "My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?" And as the time ticked, we heard the utterance, "I thirst." And it seemed that time stood still until he said, "It is finished." And then, like only Jesus could do, he uttered, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit."
Let us now turn to page 129 and rise in body and in spirit. And let's thank God for the blood that has saved you and I. We're going to sing that hymn of the church that says, "I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was lost, he died on the cross. I know it was the blood that saved me."
Lost. Jesus. Thank you for the blood. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person. Though perhaps for a good person, someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we still were sinners, Christ died for us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I stand in awe.
Jesus said to them, "Come and have breakfast." Now, none of the disciples dared to ask him, "Who are you?" because they knew it was the Lord. Jesus came and took the bread and gave it to them and did the same with the fish. This was now the third time that Jesus appeared to the disciples after he was risen from the dead. When they had finished breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" He said to him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." A second time he asked him, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" He said to them, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Tend my sheep." And he said to him the third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter felt hurt because he said to him the third time, "Do you love me?" And he said to him, "Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep." And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In spirit and sing with us verse 1, verse 2, and then we're going to do verse 1 again and then greet each other as we sing verse 1 for the third time.
Receive ye this good word. Go ye therefore and teach all nations. Go, go, go. Go ye therefore and teach all nations. Go, go, go. Baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. go, go, go. And always remember, in the words of Jesus, that I'll be with you forever and ever 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 until the end of the world. So, go, 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 and go. May the Lord bless you.